God commands that we live holy lives. That's why He commands us to repent. So don't assume on His mercies. Don't assume that you have tomorrow. You're not guaranteed tomorrow. And you know, if you look across the street here, behind me, there's this house right here, and it's got a fence around it. And if I were to jump over that fence and I were to run up that door and knock on that door, nothing's going to happen to me. The guy's probably going to open the door and say, "Hey, who are you?" But if that was the White House fence and I jumped over the White House fence and ran up to the White House front door, I'm going to have a mob of Secret Service tackle me. I'm probably going to end up in jail for at least a year or two. And I'm going to have all kinds of evaluations going on, because everybody knows you don't jump over the White House fence and run up to the White House. Same offense, trespassing. The difference is who you've trespassed against. So while we look at this sign here that says no trespassing, if I were to walk along this sidewalk and through this parking lot, yeah, they call the Fresno PD and I'd probably get a citation for trespassing, but nothing's gonna happen. I'm gonna be at home tonight. I'll be in bed tonight. It's a small, minor misdemeanor infraction. But if you trespass against God and you die in your sins, there's an eternal penalty in His place called hell. Heaven is pro-life. Jesus Christ is an abolitionist. He came to abolish sin. He came to abolish death. This place is a place of sin and death. This place violates His command. That's what sin is. Sin is breaking God's commands. 1 John 3:4. This place violates God's command that you shall not murder. It violates His command not to hurt people. So we urge you today to repent. Put your trust in Jesus Christ. You're not guaranteed tomorrow. You're not guaranteed your next heartbeat. And when you stand before God, if you die in your sins, you will remember this day that you heard the preaching and the pleading. You will remember our voices if you end up in hell. So we urge you, repent. We're out here because we care. It'd be very unloving for us not to warn you. Just like if we were to watch a blind man walk off a cliff and not warn him that there was a cliff and not say, "Hey, blind man, turn around. There's a cliff. You're going to die." It would be unloving and uncompassionate. And it would be very unloving and uncompassionate to let you guys stand out here and come to this place and not warn you that this place is a place that kills children. And when you stand before God, God will judge you as a murderer that supports a place that kills children. And if there was nothing wrong with this place, nobody would ever care that we were out here. Just the fact that people don't like us here, and they don't like signs of aborted babies, the images, shows that they know the truth. God's law is written on their hearts. Nobody wants to see an aborted baby. Have you ever gone in here and watched an abortion, sir? Have you ever watched a live abortion on YouTube, sir? Have you ever watched a live abortion on YouTube? You should go volunteer to watch an abortion. Maybe you can start putting the scissors in the faces and tearing the brains out, because that's what you support when you support this place. This place kills children. And there's a lot of people that are pro-choice, but they won't look at the images and they won't watch the videos because it's so disturbing. And they know it's wrong.